What is Olympism, and how does it unite us? It's the early morning riser, driven not by glory, but to achieve a personal best. The coach who inspires their pupil to be the greatest they can be, understanding that it's not the win, but the journey of how they got there. The volunteer who breaks down barriers and builds bridges with every greeting. The photographer who lives to capture the power of the human spirit in a single frame. The refugee whose sporting participation is a powerful signal of hope. The rivals who become teammates and help build a more peaceful world. The parent who drives their daughter to team practice every day, contributing to a bright future for women in sport. The community that respects the environment.
Bohu tarangakaruan atharamaga tarange athara tamatte me punchi minisa seelu tarangawata nimakaramin tarange avasane santuhan kale samatama adarshayak wenin ohuta hinehunu dasadahas sankhyata krida lolin avasane tama asun walin nagi sita olwarasan handatemin ධෛර්යවන්ත ඔහුව ඇගීමට ලක් කළේ හදවතින්මයි.
Fernando Celan is really pouring out a burst of speed right now as he crosses the finish line. The final man to finish his men's 10,000 meter event and a great shot going up from the stand.
මාමේ තරඟයට සහභාගී වුණේ තරඟය ආරම්භ වන්නම පමණක් නොවේ. ඒ අවසන් කරන්නට බවත් ලෝකයටම කියා දුන් මේ දිරිය මිනිසා පිළිබඳව ජපානයේ පාසල් පෙළ පොත්වලක් ලියවුණා. ලංකාවේ අපි නොදත් නමුත් ලොවම දිනු මේ ගෞරවනීය ශ්‍රී ලාංකික මිනිසා ඔලිම්පික් ඉතිහාසයටත් මුළු ලෝකයටම කියා දුන්නේ මිල කළ නොහැකි පාඩමක්.
Debbie Ferguson, Susan J. Singh, Melinda Gainsford-Taylor and Jana Pintasevich. Blankers-Cohen, Fanny Blankers-Cohen, Marjorie Jackson, Betty Cuthbert, Wilma Rudolph, Renata Stecker and Flo Jo are the women that have done the 100-200 double. Miss Kathy.
There's no doubt that we're going to see it here tonight. It's just going to be by how far, I feel. Marion is undoubtedly the most superior athlete in this event. And really, the question is going to be, will she go into 22 seconds and by how far? And then we will battle it out for the minor medals.
Yes, who gets second and third? McDonald looked terrific until the semi-final. She's got a poor draw lane one.
Shocking draw lane one for McDonald. Very tight, very hard to use your speed.
The Australian Cathy Freeman, the gold medalist in the 400 in two.
It's a different girl.
It's a bonus, isn't it?
One of the nice things that I can say about my life is that Cathy's a friend of mine.
Pauline Davis, of 34 years of age, ran fourth in the 400 behind Parekh and Freeman 4 years ago, her first Olympic 200 final.
I don't know whether she's got it, but she ran a reasonable semi.
Well, she looks on for a second one here to join some of the legends, doesn't she, Marion Jones?
Very relaxed, blinking, double blinking at the camera. She has a job to do. She's got a bit more pressure on her these days. Razor, very relaxed, very relaxed.
Lane 5, Debbie Ferguson, finalist last year, made the 100 final here, and with Pauline Davis from the Bahamas.
Second Bahaman, she's got a very serious job. She's going to have Jones going through her very quickly.
Jay Singh's been in good form, but looked a bit tight again in the semi.
Jay Singh ran a great 150, and then a very ordinary last 50 in the semi-final.
So Sri Lanka has a finalist. Here's Melinda.
We have two.
It's her town, isn't it?
It is her town, and it's her night.
And Pintasevich, who won the world title 3 years ago in lane 8.
Don't think she can do it tonight, but she could set Melinda up for a good run.
So, Jones, by how far really? But upsets occur, and if she does win, who gets second and third?
I don't think it'll be as close as my race in 72 with Stecker.
No, we've had some wide margins. We certainly have. That was 0.05. There's Melinda Gaines for Taylor. As Raylene said, the biggest day in her athletic life. She's made the final of the 200. Pauline Davis, Debbie Ferguson, the two from the Bahamas. And there's Davis and Kathy Freeman down low. Has to get out quickly. She'll take some scalps late, and who knows how far she can bring herself up the field. How quick will Jones be? Surely it's a second gold medal. She's going for five here, the long jump final tomorrow night, and then the relays on the weekend.
Tense moment. Very tense moment. The butterflies you've got to control, the crowd noise you've got to control, and you have to get out fast and move hard around that turn. Get a flick off the turn into the home straight, and then run as rapidly as you can to the line.
Marion Jones in four, Kathy Freeman two, Melinda Gaines for Taylor in seven. Final of the women's 200, two Aussies there. In fact, Bev McDonald's put a hand out, didn't she?
Yes, Bev McDonald's not happy with the noise of the crowd, I would suggest. So she's asked for the field to be stood up.
The long jump final is so close event, isn't it? They're in the back straight.
And with the rhythmic clapping they like of the long jump to get themselves stirred up and moving along, it can be quite distracting between events. There's always so much going on at the track, not just one.
Maybe it's just a slight dry mouth for Marion Jones. She was just devastating in the 100. Here's Melinda. Let's hope she has the rest of her life. She can get a medal if she can hang on in the last 50. And Kathy could perhaps get into the frame too if she can be close enough to put pressure on those around her.
Melinda can be well set up by Pinasevich. Ran a very hard turn and
21.85, and the Aussies are about 5th and 7th.
What do you say about that?
Jay Singh third, just 1/100th between them. Jay Singh running a national record. Kathy slow to begin. We knew she would be, and Melinda out wide.
I don't think Kath was quite as slow as she was in the semi. McDonald's run very well, and Jones has run extremely well in the middle. Jay Singh's last look like cruising.
1/100th of a second. It's a stunning margin. And for the Australians, 6th for Melinda Gaines, but in 22.42, her fastest this year. And
pace as they round the turn. Halted the USA, number 338, and his teammate Cochran, number 339. Despite the staggered lanes, are forging to the front.
Okay, sir.
Are you?
We'll be right back.
Early morning riser, driven not by glory, but to achieve a personal best. The coach who inspires their pupil to be the greatest they can be, understanding that it's not the win, but the journey of how they got there. The volunteer who breaks down barriers and builds bridges with every greeting. The photographer who lives to capture the power of the human spirit in a single frame. The refugee whose sporting participation sends a powerful signal of hope. The rivals who become teammates and help build a more peaceful world. The parent who drives their daughter to team practice every day, contributing to a bright future for women in sport. The community that respects the environment and ensures the playing field can be used for generations to come. The athlete who has the courage to celebrate their diversity and inspire a more inclusive society. And the school kid, learning both to dream big and live in the moment. They may not all be Olympians, but they are Olympism in action. Excellence, friendship, and respect. Tolerance, equality, and hope. The belief that we can build a better world through sport. This is what Olympism means to us. On the 23rd of June, we can all be united as we celebrate the 70th anniversary of Olympic Day. A chance to embrace the Olympic values, get active, and discover new sports. Advancing the role of sport in society is a team effort. So, we want to hear from you. What does Olympism mean to you? And how do you live it? Together, we can build a better world through sport.
Thank you. Thank you.
On their marks for the 400-meter hurdles, and they're away to a good start. White of Ceylon, number 22, sets the pace as they round the turn. Halt of the USA, number 338, and his teammate Cochran, number 339, despite the staggered lanes, are forging to the front.
ජාතික ඔලිම්පික් ක්‍රීඩාංගණය ලංකාවේ අපි තවමත් හඳුනා නොගත් නමුත් ඔලිම්පික් මීටර් 10,000 ධාවන තරගයේ මුළු ලොවම හඳුනාගත් ධෛර්යම ශ්‍රී ලාංකික ක්‍රීඩකයා ඔහු නමින් රණතුංග කරුණානන්ද ඇමරිකානු ජාතික බිලි මිල්ස් තරගයේ රන් පදක්කම දිනක් කරුණානන්ද මහතා සිව්වතාවක් යමු. එනම් තරගයේ ජයග්‍රාහකයන් ඔහුව අභිභවා ගොස් තරගය නිම කරන විට ඔහු සිටියේ වට හතරක් පසුපසින්.
They're lapping Ceylon's Karunananda. Karunananda of Ceylon wearing number 67. They've just passed him. Rather difficult job in this distance. Ceylon's Karunananda running easily, but unfortunately in last place. Just this is men's 10,000 meter event, and a great shout is going up from the stand.
Mami tarangayata sahabhagi wune tarangaya arambannama pamanak novei e avasan karannata bavath lokeyatama kiya dun me diriya minisa pilibandawa japane pasal pilaputwalak liyabuna lankawa api nodath namuth ලොවම දිනූ මේ ගෞරවනීය ශ්‍රී ලාංකික මිනිසා ඔලිම්පික් ඉතිහාසයටත් මුළු ලෝකයටම කියා දෙන්නේ මිල කළ නොහැකි පාඩමක්.
What we do here is go
It's the early morning riser, driven not by to be the greatest they can be. UG, whose sporting participation sends a powerful signal of hope. The rivals who become teammates and help build a more peaceful world. The community that respects the environment and ensures the playing field can be used for generations to come.
වර්ෂය 1968 මීටර් දසදහසේ ධාවන තරගයෙන් මුළු ලොවම හඳුනාගත් ඇමරිකානු ජාතික බිලි මිල්ස් තරගයේ රට හතරක් පසුපසින්
They're lapping Ceylon's Kadunanda, Kadunananda of Ceylon wearing number 67. They've just passed him. rather difficult shelf coming on under, running easily, but unfortunately in last place. He's just been lapped.
Melinda Gaines for Taylor and Jana Pintasevic. Blankers Cohen, Fanny Blankers Cohen, Marjorie Jackson, Betty Cuthbert, Wilma Rudolph, Renata Stepper and Flo Jo are the women that have done the 100-200 double. Miss Kathy.
There's no doubt that we're going to see it here tonight. It's just going to be by how far, I feel. Marion is undoubtedly the most superior athlete in this event. And really, the question is going to be, will she go into 22 seconds and by how far? And then we will battle it out for the minor medals.
Yes, who gets second and third? McDonald looked terrific until the semi-final. She's got a poor draw lane one.
Shocking draw lane one for McDonald. Very tight, very hard to use your speed.
The Australian Kathy Freeman, the gold medalist in the 400 in two.
It's a different girl.
It's a bonus, isn't it?
One of the nice things that I can say about my life is that Kathy's a friend of mine.
Pauline Davis, of 34 years of age, ran fourth in the 400 behind Parekh and Freeman 4 years ago, her first Olympic 200 final.
I don't know whether she's got it, but she ran a reasonable semi.
Well, she looks on for a second one here to join some of the legends, doesn't she, Marion Jones?
Very relaxed, blinking, double blinking at the camera. She has a job to do. She's got a bit more pressure on her these days. Razor, very relaxed, very relaxed.
Lane 5, Debbie Ferguson, finalist last year, made the 100 final here, and with Pauline Davis from the Bahamas.
Second Bahaman. She's got a very serious job. She's going to have Jones going through her very quickly.
Jay Singh's been in good form, but looked a bit tight again in the semi.
Jay Singh ran a great 150, and then a very ordinary last 50 in the semi-final.
So Sri Lanka has a finalist. Here's Melinda.
We have two.
It's her town, isn't it?
It is her town, and it's her night.
And Pintasevic, who won the world title 3 years ago in lane 8.
Don't think she can do it tonight, but she could set Melinda up for a good run.
So, Jones, by how far really? But upsets occur, and if she does win, who gets second and third?
I don't think it'll be as close as my race in 72 with Stecker.
No, we've had some wide margins. We certainly have. That was 0.05. There's Melinda Gaines for Taylor. As Raylene said, the biggest day in her athletic life. She's made the final of the 200. Pauline Davis, Debbie Ferguson, the two from the Bahamas. And there's Davis and Kathy Freeman down low. Has to get out quickly. She'll take some scalps late, and who knows how far she can bring herself up the field. How quick will Jones be? Surely it's a second gold medal. She's going for five here, the long jump final tomorrow night, and then the relays on the weekend.
Tense moment. Very tense moment. The butterflies you've got to control, the crowd noise you've got to control, and you have to get out fast and move hard around that turn. Get a flick off the turn into the home straight, and then run as rapidly as you can to the line.
Marion Jones in four, Kathy Freeman two, Melinda Gaines for Taylor in seven. Final of the women's 200, two Aussies there. In fact, Bev McDonald's put a hand out, didn't she?
Yes, Bev McDonald's not happy with the noise of the crowd, I would suggest. So she's asked for the field to be stood up.
The long jump final is so close to this event, isn't it? They're in the back straight.
And with the rhythmic clapping they like of the long jump to get themselves stirred up and moving along, it can be quite distracting between events. There's always so much going on at the track. It's not just one event.
Maybe it's just a slight dry mouth for Marion Jones. She was just devastating in the 100. Here's Melinda. Let's hope she has the race of her life. She can get a medal if she can hang on in the last 50. And Kathy could perhaps get into the frame too if she can be close enough to put pressure on those around her.
Melinda can be well set up by Pintasevic in the early part, and Jones coming through, if she can go with her, will be great up the home straight.
So Jones in the middle, Gaines for Taylor to the left, and Freeman to the right once they start. Women's 200 final, almost set. Away, Melinda got out reasonably well. Jones got a terrific start, so did Ferguson. Freeman slow early, she'll be last into the stretch. Gainsford about fifth. Jones clearly in front of Jay Singh, Peter Savage. Melinda coming through, Kathy still eighth place. Jones clearly in front. Freeman can't get a medal. Melinda battling on. Jones will in front of Jay Singh and also Davis. Jones brilliant, 21.85. And the Aussies are about fifth and sixth.
What do you say about that? 21.85, that is brilliant running. And it looks so easy. She blew them away off the blocks. McDonald went with her, ran a very hard turn, and just looked magnificent up the home straight. Full of composure, full of good form, ran extremely well. Melinda's run a great race. We can't deny that. Fifth in the Olympic final.
Fifth or sixth she's been, not far away. 21.84 for Jones. Davis has got second with Jay Singh third, just 1/100th between them. Jay Singh running a national record. Kathy slow to begin, we knew she would be, and Melinda out wide.
I don't think Kath was quite as slow as she was in the semi. McDonald's run very well, and Jones has run extremely well in the middle. Jay Singh's run a good turn as well. Melinda didn't pick up Pinasevich, which I think she should have, but Jones is just leading into the straight, looking magnificent. She makes running fast look like so easy. It's just ridiculous. There she goes. McDonald's still running well on the inside. Jay Singh's still running well on the outside. Ferguson's starting to come through, as is Davis. Brilliant race, but Jones is just cruising. She's making it look very easy. Probably the largest margin in history, or very close to it.
It is very, very close. Wilma Rudolph won by 45/100ths, and she's won by 43/100ths of a second. It's a stunning margin. And for the Australian, sixth for Melinda Gainsford in 22.42, her fastest this year. And
what is Olympism, and how does it unite us? It's the early morning riser, driven not by glory, but to achieve a personal best. The coach who inspires their pupil to be the greatest they can be, understanding that it's not the win, but the journey of how they got there. The volunteer who breaks down barriers and builds bridges with every greeting. The photographer who lives to capture the power of the human spirit in a single frame. The refugee whose sporting participation sends a powerful signal of hope. The rivals who become teammates and help build a more peaceful world.
Running fast look like so easy. It's just ridiculous. There she goes. McDonald's still running well on the inside. Jay Singh's still running well on the outside. Ferguson's starting to come through, as is Davis. Brilliant race, but Jones is just cruising. She's making it look very easy. Probably the largest margin in history, or very close to it.
It is very, very close. Wilma Rudolph won by 45/100ths, and she's won by 43/100ths of a second. It's a stunning margin. And for the Australian, sixth for Melinda Gainsford in 22.42, her fastest this year. And
what we do here is go back.
මේ පුංචි මිනිසා සීලු තරඟවට නිම කරමින් තරඟයේ අවසානයේ සනිටුහන් කළේ සැමටම ආදර්ශයක් වෙමින්. ඔහුට හිනැහුණු දසදහස් සංඛ්‍යාත ක්‍රීඩාලෝලීන් අවසානයේ තම අසුන්වලින් නැගී සිට ඔල්වරසන් හඬ දෙමින් ධෛර්යවන්ත ඔහුව ඇගීමට ලක් කළේ හදවතින්මයි.
Fernando Celani is really pouring out a burst of speed right now as he crosses the finish line. The final man has finished his men's 10,000 meter event, and a great shout is going up from the stand.
Mame tarangayata sahabhagi wune tarangaye arambannama pamanak nove. E avasan karannata bavat lokeyatama kiya dun me diriya minisa pilibandawa Japane paasal pila putpalak liyabuna. ලංකාවේ අපි නොදත් නමුත් ලොවම දිනූ මේ ගෞරවනීය ශ්‍රී ලාංකික මිනිසා ඔලිම්පික් ඉතිහාසයටත් මුළු ලෝකයටම කියා දෙන්නේ මිල කළ නොහැකි පාඩමක්.
What we do here is go back, 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 back.
the celebration of the Olympic Day is once of the Sri Lanka Tennis Association, over 100 years old. And as Sakshi got through the help of the National Olympic Committee of Sri Lanka,
government agent Murilia, DIG Murilia, Susanta Jayasinghe, my family, and it is my great pleasure, my first official duty. I had come to the place early in 1973. The tennis that I play, that is one reason I want to. Honorable Chief Minister, thank you very much. I am waiting for the occasion.
It's the early morning riser, driven not by glory, but to achieve a personal best. The coach who inspires their pupil to be the greater can be, understanding that it's not the win, but the journey of out there. The volunteer puts down barriers and builds bridges with every greeting. Photographer who lives to capture it in a single frame. The refugee whose sporting part is a powerful signal of hope. The rivals who become kids and help build a more peaceful world. The parent who drives their daughter to team practice every day, contributing to a bright future for women in sport. The community that respects the environment and ensures the playing field can be used for generations to come. The athlete who has the courage to celebrate their diversity and a more inclusive